It'd really be nice to have a do-over if our habits or our genes have led us to develop plaque in our arteries. I suppose it doesn't need much explanation, but having less space in your arteries because you have a cholesterol-packed plaque cutting into your blood circulation is a recipe for disaster, from stroke to heart attack and more. So, is it then possible for something like exercise, which we know benefits our health, to give us that do-over by erasing the plaque found in our arteries? Ultimately, what we care about is avoiding the outcome of death, and just before that, cardiovascular events like stroke, heart attacks, and so on. Fascinatingly, exercise can help prevent that from happening through more than just removing plaque from our arteries. According to this scientific review, the researchers acknowledge that exercise can reduce plaque in our arteries, but how exactly? Well, plaque formation is a combination of multiple factors coming together to allow for an atheroma, that's the plaque, to build. In brief, your blood vessel wall has these proteins under an initial layer of cells called endothelial cells. These proteins, called proteoglycans, attract a type of particle called an ApoB-containing lipoprotein. These lipoproteins bind to the proteoglycans and can be oxidized or modified. In doing so, this leads to a cascade of events, from immune cells invading the area to the formation of a necrotic core, which involves the death of immune cells under the endothelial layer. And as this continues to progress, the atheroma grows. Ultimately, it pushes into the open area of the blood vessel, where blood flow is supposed to be occurring, called the lumen. This is important because if the lumen completely closes, there's no more blood flow that goes downstream to the rest of the body. That means a lack of nutrients, oxygen, clearing of metabolites, and more. This is called an occlusion. We'll return to some more specifics on all that, because there's something unique that exercise does to that atheroma aside from shrinking it, but how does it shrink it, at least mechanistically? Remember when we briefly discussed the immune cells invading the forming atheroma to deal with the stuck lipoproteins? Well, they invade under the endothelial layer because they consume these lipoproteins in an attempt, at least assumed, to eliminate the growing lipoprotein burden. However, they then turn into foam cells. These are immune cells that are overladen with these lipoproteins and end up dysfunctional cells. These dysfunctional cells recruit more immune cells, but they also die, creating a necrotic core discussed earlier. Anyway, exercise seems to reinvigorate these lipoprotein burden immune cells to migrate back out of the atheroma. In addition, exercise can reduce the lipoprotein burden, thereby reducing the uptake of these lipoproteins into the subendothelium. In addition, exercise affects other lipoprotein types called HDL. HDL, or high-density lipoproteins, are not bound to these proteoglycans because they do not contain the ApoB section that is chemically attracted to the proteoglycans. However, HDLs have the capacity to pick up cholesterol molecules stuck inside the cells and inside the ApoB-containing lipoproteins through a number of transport mechanisms. In doing so, they can efflux or liberate cholesterol molecules from the atheroma and return it to the liver to be excreted. This is called reverse cholesterol transport. So that's three ways by which exercise reduces the size of the plaque, the atheroma. I'm sure there are some complex signaling processes that are the driving force for all that happening, but I'd like to get into some of the non-plaque related ways that exercise can also help prevent you from tasting the corroded lips of death. We're still leaning on this review, and therein it's pointed out that exercise can also collateralize blood vessels. I'll straight up tell you that I had no idea what that meant, but fortunately, with my superior 10 IQ intellect, I was able to manage to look it up and learn about it so that I could pretend like I knew all along right here for you. Collateralized blood vessels are blood vessels that can become active when the main blood vessel is incapable of transporting nutrients and oxygen as necessary. Essentially, exercise promotes the process of angiogenesis, a word that I have heard before, wherein your body produces more blood vessels. In doing so, these blood vessels can attach downstream from the occlusion or near occlusion, therefore creating a natural, non-surgical installed bypass, which is honestly really freaking cool. What's fascinating is that the triggers of this bypass formation are A, ischemia, or the lack of blood flow, but also B, the way that the fluid rubs across the atheroma and the surrounding region. Apparently that stimulates the blood vessel to start sprouting a new blood flow system. That is crazy. In fact, that process is so efficient that some people no longer feel chest pains when they previously did from the original atheroma growing. But there's something else that exercise does that's seldom discussed, but we'll get into that. First, let's discuss the clinical evidence from exercise shrinking plaque, and then I'd like to get into some of the applicable information. Okay, there are a few randomized controlled trials that have looked into this. Unfortunately, I covered them both in the past, and someone astutely brought up that this one had some major statistical mistakes, which makes the interpretation difficult. Yet, if we demote that study and focus on the other, there's some intriguing findings. In that study, researchers randomly assigned people with cardiovascular disease to a moderate continuous endurance training or high intensity interval training. These men and women performed the exercise 3 times per week for 12 weeks and had their exercise capacity measured. But more importantly for us, they measured arterial plaque as well. Unfortunately, most of the measures did not indicate an improvement. However, one measure, the size of the necrotic core that we discussed earlier, was reduced in both exercise groups. In fact, although it isn't overly objective, here's an image of the artery of a person measured. On the left, before exercise, and on the right, after exercise. The more red, the more necrotic core, and the more green, the more fibrous tissue, something that we haven't discussed yet, but we will, because it's linked to this additional benefit of exercise. Now, the less statistically rigorous study had more impressive results, but I wouldn't feel comfortable adding that data here, because it may be because of their statistical mistakes that they had more impressive results. However, in the scientific review that we went over, they reference a few other studies of varying quality. So, I would like to see more concrete data, but across mechanisms and some clinical data, exercise does seem to reduce plaque. Now, how do we go about erasing plaque from our arteries? Well, as we discussed, both a moderate intensity endurance training and a higher intensity training led to plaque improvements. However, the review mentions that a target to aim for is to burn 2,200 calories per week, equivalent to about 5 to 6 hours of exercise per week. What they also point out is that exercise alone may be insufficient, or at least it may not produce the potent effect unless paired with other factors, especially one, reducing the number of ApoB-containing lipoproteins in the blood, and two, possibly reductions in blood pressure as well. Both can be achieved through nutrition, weight loss, or drugs. What I also noticed is that there's an exercise protocol that keeps being brought up across multiple studies and seems to have the most robust effects in improving heart health, including plaque reversal. I've put together that step-by-step protocol for the Physionic Insiders if you're interested. It's linked in the description, and you get a host of other benefits. Now, there's something else that exercise does to your plaque, but it's a bit nuanced. According to another review, the researchers point out that there's some mixture in the studies in reference to the effect exercise has on plaque stability. That means that we aren't just concerned about the plaque being present, but also how it is present. Is it a stable plaque or unstable? Unstable plaque means that the top section, the most protruding section of the atheroma, is capped by a thin fibrotic cap. Essentially, cells lay down collagen and other proteins on top of the cholesterol, the immune cells, lipoprotein mixture, and try to make sure that it doesn't break off from the sheer stress of blood pressure rubbing against it every moment of the day. If the top breaks off, it creates a blood clot that can occlude a downstream blood vessel. So having a thin fibrotic cap is unstable and ready to be ripped off to create a blood clot. However, a thick fibrous cap or a calcified cap could stabilize the atheroma so that while it might still exist, it won't break into a clot. Interestingly, there's some evidence that exercise can increase the calcification of plaque, measured via a coronary artery calcification score, a CAC score. However, that evidence is a bit all over the place, with some studies indicating otherwise. For example, in athletes, people who exercise a lot, the dark blue bars represent their plaque makeup. Clearly, there's more calcified plaque, but less mixed plaque, which is the most volatile and dangerous, according to the researchers. To be clear, this is not set in stone, so there's room for more data, just like everything related to the subject. Still, the researchers concluded that the net is a benefit of exercise through likely plaque stabilization, but also some other mechanisms that we didn't even have time to discuss here. So the takeaway here is that there's a mixed quality evidence that exercise reverses plaque, but the evidence tentatively points to it being possible through a number of mechanisms. I do think some other conditions need to be met for the best effects, like working on reducing blood pressure and ApoB burden. But the exercise also provides unique ways of protecting against plaque-induced problems, even aside from the shrinking of the plaque itself. In fact, one more way that exercise improves heart health is by giving mini heart attacks. No, I am not joking. It's called cardiac preconditioning, explained in this next video. Or you might be more interested in some of my other work right here. Thanks for watching.